you cross your porch?
No.
Well, I gotta help you cross something.
No, I'm doing fine.
Okay, right, with the recent vlogs, a lot of you have been saying how like motivational it's been and how it's left you feeling more like productive and ready to work. So I thought with this video, what I would try is start with kind of a lesser pace and gradually build the pace, the energy, the music and all of that throughout the video so that it leaves you on the peak and ready just to smash out everything you want to do. But anyway, this vlog is absolutely packed and there's something in here for everyone. So sit back, relax, grab a coffee, grab a tea, I don't know, whatever you drink. And yeah, just enjoy it. But anyway, in the last video, I went over the 3 steps of getting your together. And a big part of that is clarity and having the mental headspace or bandwidth to be able to take on everything you want with a clear, driven mind and be able to do everything with intent. Now, obviously, I've always talked about having like a clean working environment and how that complements to kind of that clarity and that idea of focus and intent and is kind of reflective of your mental state at the time. But I've never really thought about digital space, which is why when Identity reached out to me and said they had a solution to digital mindfulness to declutter the internet and give you more intent when you're working on any form of technology, you already know that I was down for it because honestly, if it can help me, then it's going to be able to help you. So I wanted to try it out. I wanted to see if it was good. For the last week, I've been using it. I've been trying it out and I've been seeing if it's going to be something that I want to recommend to you guys. So what actually is it? Let me show you. Okay, so pretty much, Identity aims to be the browser that allows you to declutter the internet, remove the stresses of just unnecessary tabs, keep track of everything you do online, and have everything in one simple space, which would ultimately allow you to do everything you normally would, but with more focus, intent, and ultimately less distraction. So for example, like when I'm on my laptop or my computer and I'm trying to focus on a specific task, I always find myself drifting away from that and onto just the mass of different tabs and things that I have open that kind of tempt me to drift off of that task, if that makes sense. So for example, when I'm editing a video, I might get caught up in emails and start editing those and then looking at some revision or something like that, and I don't have that clear intent to edit that video, and it just breaks my flow state and doesn't really help me to stay focused, productive, and get as much as possible done that I could. Or what I find most of the time is I'll be trying to revise and do work on things like Anki and stuff like that, but then I'll find myself, because it's all just there, I end up drifting towards editing and making these videos because it's like more enjoyable, and that's a really big problem for me. But that's what Identity tries to solve. To give you that idea of mindfulness when you're working. This is pretty much how it does that. Basically, you have these things called tiles on your web page, and these are all of like the frequent websites you visit and the things you need to do your work, to edit videos and all of that. But instead of having it all just appear as one big mass, as you would with like bookmarks and stuff, you can search through it to give yourself more intent. So for example, if I want to just start working, all I need to do is search work. It removes all of the unnecessary tabs and gives you that intent and allows you just to access the flow state a bit more easily, because everything is out of sight, out of mind, and you're ready to work. And that's great. So for example, I've got one for work, I've got one for finance, I've got one for YouTube, I've got one for school, and that's all there. It just keeps me aware of the key things with that. That would be great on its own, but what makes it kind of a step above anything else out there at the moment is the fact that it has a Google Calendar built in. Just to clarify, it actually imports your Google Calendar, so you don't have to remake a new one. It takes everything that you've already made and puts it into this. Cool. If you come to the right hand side of my Identity browser, it comes up with my calendar. So this is all of the tasks I planned throughout the day. And so for today, I've got a massively packed day, as I said, but basically wake up, I've got math cue cards for 2.5 hours, then I've got a meeting with an on-demand course, and then as you can see, mechanics, physics, dinner, arms, whatever, just all of the work that I need to be getting on with. And it breaks it down into a really nice schedule. So I've got kind of all of the stuff that I need, I've got what I need to be doing throughout the day, and then the best part is it's also a built-in task management app. So for example, as I outlined in my last video, if you watched that, the getting my together video, basically I talk about having open blocks of time where you need to do tasks and then a list of the tasks that you need to do so that you can drag it into those time slots. This allows you to do that because you've got obviously the times, like you can see that you need to be doing the certain tasks, but then if you go into these notes and these lists, you can set tasks or set the specific tasks that you need to be doing. So these are the mechanics cues that I need to make. And another great part of this is you can actually set launches with those tasks. So rather than just having the task and then needing to find out how you can do that, you can can set the specific website for that task so that I click it and then I'm straight onto the resource that I need to be able to do that. It just streamlines your work a bit and just allows you to be that like 5-10% more productive. And then again, if you want to be more clinical, you can even set things like due dates. So if I want to set a due date for, let's go Monday, because that's when my exams kind of start, I just click that, insert due date, and it tells me it's due by 4th of the 19th. And yeah, that's identity. So yeah, I've been using this over the last week and it's honestly been an absolute godsend. Now it's all completely free to use, it's the easiest thing to download, it adds it to your Chrome, and then you can set it as your default browser, so whenever you open up Chrome, Safari, Firefox or anything, it will just launch that, and that's brilliant. So if you want to support the channel, obviously there's a like button, obviously there's commenting, but a massive thing would be if you go down to the description and download Identity for whatever computer you use. I've actually got it on both my computer and my laptop. It's helped me, I'm sure it can help you. Anyway, let's crack on with literally everything that we need to do. Today is going to be an 8-hour study day, it's going to be mental, let's get started.
Yeah, high up life, low on sleep, down on luck, I've been up all week. Maybe you could be somebody that saves me, I've been faded quite lately. It's no fun when you're alone. Now I gotta call it.
Okay, we are now 1 hour in, and basically today I'm going to be experimenting with the length of Pomodoro sessions. So usually I do 25 minutes, 5 minutes, but a lot of you have been wanting me to do like longer sessions. So today I'm going to mix it up. I'm starting on 50 minutes on, 10 minutes off. So I'm now an hour in. I've got a 10 minute break, then we hit the next 50 minutes. And then that should take me up to around about the meeting where I've got to discuss this on-demand course for this, the class ninjas that I'm working for that I posted on the community tab a while ago. But anyway, hour two, let's go.
My car broke down, dead battery. I've been blocked off my Uber. The drivers, if you ask me, cause I was smelling like an ounce, like a Zap Roger summertime bounce. I came here to get lifted, I'll be surfing on clouds.
Oh, also, I've just had a massive revelation, so I'm going to take about quickly 20 minutes to deviate from that plan that I set out, because like, I'm going to basically put everything on hold and drop it again when we hit 100,000 subscribers. So for those of you who have already got some, amazing, because you're going to be the only ones for a very long time. Okay, right, so time is now 11:30 and I've got a call to discuss an on-demand course. But the sick thing about this is you can literally open the meeting from here. You just click that, opens the meeting. Let's go. Yeah, on with the meeting.
What you mean? Trust me, everything is better with the green. Don't kill my vibe, don't blow my buzz, cause I'm a fiend. Menage a trois, let's make it three. Selfish, I need you for me.
Okay, we're now 2 hours in. I'm shattered, but we're going strong, we're going good. I'm drip feeding the caffeine, so I kind of feel constantly somewhat energized. But time is now 12. I'm gonna go downstairs, grab a quick snack. We can come up and hit another 2 hours of the Pomodoro work. I might stretch it and go for three if it means I can have lunch a little later. Like if I get into the flow state and I'm able to do that, I'm gonna do that. But yeah, back to lunch now. Hours 3 and 4. Let's go.
Cause I need your company and I want it right now. Right now, baby, I'ma need another hit. I want your love. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Baby, I'ma need another hit. I want your love. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale.
Okay, basically we've just finished all of the cue cards for the what's it called, maths, for that segment. So we're now 4 hours in to the study day, and it means we can go to the identity, we can go on to the pure maths cue cards left to make and check off the vectors. So all of that's done, so we've now got 9 sets of cue cards to make on that, and then we've got mechanics and physics to make, and then we'll be all caught up on the cue cards and we can just crack on with the final revision. Time is now 3 o'clock. I am absolutely dying. It's been kind of like a bit of a rough set of work. Haven't been like hugely focused just because, like, I don't know, I feel like quite drained at the moment. I'm gonna go have some lunch, have a coffee, and then we'll go back up to it. Let's go. OK,
Okay, something I've been absolutely loving for the bulk are these toasted waffles.
Just one of those is 194 calories.
So two of them, 200 calories, a whack of biscuit or something on, gets lots of it in. And then obviously we've got the classic pasta, tuna pasta, red pesto, a few jalapenos, and it is a beautiful. Anyway, I'm gonna sit down, I'm gonna eat this. It is gonna be so good because I'm absolutely starving. And then we'll hit two more hours of work for a fat, fat arm workout. Let's get it. Completely honest, I did get distracted. I ended up watching the new season of Brooklyn Nine-Nine because for some reason I haven't watched it. So I watched one with those with lunch and then I just kept watching. So it is a little bit later now, which is a shame, but there's not much we can do. We can't just like focus on the fact that we haven't done it. You know, I've mentioned this in the past. Don't let like unproductive little binge stop you from being productive the rest of the time. So we're going to go and absolutely smash this workout. It's an arm workout. It is a bit of a terrible weather, but we move. Yeah, so we're doing that. Then we'll come home, have dinner. I think we're watching a movie with fam, and then hopefully after the movie, if I'm not too tired, I can go out and hit some work. It'll probably be like 9, 10, so it might be a bit of a late night study session, but I haven't had one in a while, so never know, it could be good. Anyway, workout time. Let's go.
Lighters up, one time lighters up. Pulled up in the party when you saw me, I was lighting up my J. So go ahead and brighten up my day. Lighters in the air when you're lighting up the rave, and it's feeling like I met you here before. Girl, I felt your presence when they let you through the door. Never had a brother give you everything and more. So I take a little piece and then the rest of it is yours, me and more.
You don't dare when I don't tell you, but can you taste and I play? Hey. I don't know where to you, they do me with just this guy by my brain.
Fuck loving when I put you in your place. I can tell you love it just by looking in your face. It's the way that you wind up your waist. I'm so in awe, girl, you never have to worry about nothing. You know it's yours, you know you're
holding. Girl, you just holding. Cause your body's on fire.
I don't know why, but this keeps happening now. My camera has just died again. It's down there. We just finished the workout. Absolutely solid workout here. About an hour of arms and arms and shoulders. And then we hit the burnouts on calves and then chest. So if you don't already know my plan, pretty much it's this arms focus plan. I don't like that phrasing because it makes it sound like I'm just like prioritizing arms, which I am, but I'm not like bro spitting it, if you get me. So it's still like the compound movement, but I'm predominantly doing arm based exercises in that. So things like obviously the tricep extensions, the curls and all of that. But then we have as well push day and lower day. It's like push pull legs, but the push and the pull are combined, and then the first day is arms and shoulders, if that makes sense. But by the end of it, the last 2 weeks, I do four arm, nah, it can't be four. Yeah. No, three arm workouts a week, which is pretty mental, but it's just meant to put yourself to the brink of overtraining. So by the end of the workouts, by the end of the routine, you can just eat loads, and then it's like delayed growth. It stimulates all of the fibers to grow over the next couple of weeks and just recover for the next burst. But yeah, that's that. So I'm gonna drive home now. Bike that in, have a shower, and then we're gonna hit up a movie with the family. And then later after that movie, so hold on. The movie we're watching is Kong versus Godzilla. It's the home premiere, because obviously they can't release it in cinemas. Cinemas aren't open, so they're premiering it on Amazon Prime and like other streaming services. So watch that, and then hit up a late study session. So I'm excited for the late study session because I need to get something done. Yeah, let's go. Okay, right, movie is just finished. It is 20 to 10, hold on. Yeah, 20 to 10, I see that. Ooh. 20 to 10, I've just signed up for Pure Gym because better, their pricing was ridiculous, and this one's just opened up where I live, and it's £13 a month, which is solid. Opens sometime in May, so I'm just gonna be smashing the home workouts until then. I'm just gassed to be able to go back to the gym soon-ish. So yeah, that's sick. Anyway, I'm gonna go have a shower, and then I'm gonna come back here, work out some study beats, and we're gonna crack on with some more revision. It's gonna be good, all right, let's go.
No thank you is what I should have said. I should be in bed, but temptations
of trouble on my tongue. Trouble's yet to come.
One sip,
bad for me.
One hit,
bad for me.
One kiss,
bad for me. But I give in so easily, and no thank you is how it should have gone. I should stay strong, but I'm weak. And what's wrong?
Okay, right, just before we get into this last set of work, I just want to say another massive thank you to Identity for being an absolute legend, sponsoring this video, and giving you guys this amazing workspace to use. So I'm gonna hit up work, and I can go straight on to Chilled Cow to basically listen to his lo-fi music and crack on with it. So let's get it. A couple hours of work done. It's currently 10 o'clock. Have my tea. Let's go.
No, thank you. They call me after dark. I don't want no part. My habits, they hold me like a grudge. I promise I won't budge.
One sip,
bad for me.
One hit,
bad for me.
One kiss,
bad for me. But I give in so easily, and no thank you is how it should have gone. I should stay strong, but I'm weak.
Hold on, I actually smashed it.
I am absolutely I feel like a trap, I am absolutely knackered, but I need to tie this up. It's now 7 past midnight. We've got a solid, like, 6-7 hours work done. 4 hours of study done, and then probably like 8 hours of total work and a workout. So absolutely banged. But yeah, no, I'm FaceTiming Liv in literally like 8 minutes, and she will kill me if I'm late. So I need to go and do my teeth and crack on with her now. I'll speak to you tomorrow. Fresh day. Let's go.
Okay, it is now Sunday, and I don't know how we've done it, but we've just managed to absolutely blast out that video in about 7 hours. So not quite the usual 10. Obviously, it's still quite a long time, but yeah, nah, it's fun. I enjoyed making this video, so I hope you enjoyed watching it. Yeah, it had that different pace to this one, so it kind of increased throughout. So let me know if you enjoyed that. Yeah, otherwise, I found with the Pomodoro work, the longer periods of time, I didn't get on with it super well. It kind of left me feeling a bit distracted in the 10-minute break, so I'll probably stick to the 5 minutes, but then occasionally just do like 2 hours if I feel like I could do more. And then again, obviously with the Netflix binge, that's fine. I probably watched that for about 1.5 to 2 hours. And if I hadn't done that, I would have hit that 8 hour mark of like pure study rather than 8 hours, including all of the work that I did, if that makes sense, like extra work on top of school. That's not like amazing, but it is what it is. You're allowed to have that deviance from your typical plan. Like, as you saw, I didn't stick to my plan hour by hour. I probably stuck to about 70% of it, but I still got everything that wanted to done, so it's solid. But yeah, anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to drop a like, don't forget to drop a subscribe. We've got loads more videos like this coming. You already know we've got this type of video and loads of extra more informative, like, self-improvement content coming. But for this one, that is the end. Hopefully I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.
I live inside my own world of make-believe.